So guys, as far as the third test of congruency is concerned, we already done with SSS, SAS. The third is angle side angle. Now let us say we have triangle PQR and triangle XYZ. I am interested in proving them that these two triangles are congruent. Any information given to us? Yes, sir. Information is this angle equals to this angle. This side equals to this side, and this angle is congruent to this angle. As I said, for the purpose of congruency, that means whenever you have to prove that the two triangles are congruent, we will always like to go for an information. We need three pair of information in any combination of side or angle, but definitely it has to meet to the order prescribed by the test of congruency. So when I look at this triangle, can I say in triangle PQR and triangle XYZ? My dear friend, note that I have mentioned over here and not congruent, because we have yet not proved congruent. So in triangle PQR and triangle XYZ, point number one, angle Q is equal to angle Y. Of course, I am writing the short forms. You need to write the full name of the angle. Angle Q would be nothing but PQR is equal to angle XYZ. Same way, if you go to see QR, side QR is equal to side YZ. And the third one being angle R is equal to angle Z. My dear friends, remember one thing very, very clearly. Order is very essential. Angle. After angle, you cannot directly jump onto angle, because in between there is a side. So angle, side, angle. Angle, side, angle test. That means all this information were given to us in the question. Now if you see the fourth point, can I say triangle? One-to-one correspondence is a must. We know that Q corresponds to Y. We know that R corresponds to Z. That means QR is done with, the only letter by default left is P. So P will come over here, whereas Y is Z, so X is going to come over here. So my dear friends, in triangle PQR and triangle XYZ, following information was given and we have used them. If you note, this is angle. What about this side? And this is angle. So we are complied with angle side angle test. Three things are done. These two triangles are congruent by ASA test of congruency. That means since three things are done, altogether we have six parts of triangles. So remaining three things would be congruent by CPCTC. Look at this. How many angles are done? Sir, two angles are done. Which one is left? P. Angle P equals to angle X. What about the sides? So one side is done. So we are left with now PR. PR. So PR, side PR will be equal to XZ. And also QP. Have we done QP? No. So side QP, QP will be equal to YX. So my dear friends, this is CPCTC, which means corresponding parts of congruent triangles are corresponding parts congruent triangle congruent CPCTC. This is the full form of it. So my dear friends, with this we can say or conclude that even ASA test is done with. Let us move on to the next test. So the fourth test of congruency is AAS. Take for example triangle ABC and triangle PQR. My dear friends, we have to prove that triangle ABC and triangle PQR are congruent. Any information or relevant information given to you in the question? Yes, sir. This angle is equal to this angle. Anything else? Yes, sir.
this angle is equal to this angle. Any other relevant information? Yes, sir. Sir, this time we are making small change. This side is equal to this side.
No, I don't know. I mean, like, I am only interested in finding out whether there is anything which is common between them, anything which is equal between them. What all are the possible things that can be worked out between the combination of sides and angles? In short, जब भी दो ट्राइंगल्स हम लोग को देंगे तो हम लोग को प्रूव करना है कि दोनों ट्राइंगल कॉम्बिनेट है। पहले सारी इंफॉर्मेशन जुटा लो कि क्या क्या चीजें इक्वल है और वो जो इक्वल चीजें हैं वो किस ऑर्डर में है। कॉम्बिनेशन साइड और एंगल्स का कोई भी फॉर्म में हो सकता है, बट वो फॉर्म इट हैज टू मीट विद एनी ऑफ द फॉर्म विच इज प्रिस्क्राइब्ड ओवर हियर। ऑलराइट, तो देखते हैं कि ऐसा कुछ हो रहा है या नहीं हो रहा है। द फर्स्ट थिंग, इफ यू गो टू सी, दिस एंगल इज इक्वल टू दिस एंगल, सेकंड दिस एंगल इज इक्वल टू दिस एंगल, एंगल एंगल, ऑलराइट, एंड दिस इज साइड, सो हियर आल्सो वी हैव अ साइड। मान लो यहां पे ये साइड दी हुई है और वहां पे वो साइड दी हुई है, एंगल एंगल साइड। तो सवाल ये है कि क्या ये दोनों ट्राइंगल कॉन्ग्रुएंट माने जाएंगे या नहीं माने जाएंगे। सो माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, इफ यू नोट, दिस इज ए एंगल एंगल, उसके बाद में यहाँ पे साइड नहीं है, सो वन टू वन करेस्पॉन्डेंस नहीं हो रहा है, एंगल एंगल साइड। व्हेयर इज ओवर हियर एंगल एंगल, देयर इज नो साइड ओवर हियर, सो दिस टू ट्राइंगल्स विल नॉट बी कॉन्ग्रुएंट। बट ऑफ कोर्स यस, इफ आई मेक वन मॉडिफिकेशन, इफ आई रिमूव दिस साइड ओवर हियर and if I put this side over here as same, and now if you review that, so you will notice that angle, 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 angle. So basically, angle, yes sir, angle, yes sir. After this two passage of angle, what do you get? Side, side. It is meeting to this, of course it is meeting to this. So definitely these two triangles can be proved congruent. So my dear friends, this is AAS. The one-to-one correspondence is a very unique and a very important thing because of which we can say that the two triangles are congruent. So now you will look into this triangle. In triangle ABC and triangle PQR. So we have a triangle ABC, we have a triangle PQR. What information is given to us? Sir, angle B is equal to angle Q. Wow. We have to write the full form of the angle, though I have written over here the shortcut. So angle B is corresponding to angle Q. You can check it out, one to one correspondence. After that, sir, angle C is equal to angle R. Here also you can see there is a one to one correspondence, both are equal. Third one, sir, side AC is equal to side PR. So now if you notice, angle, angle, side. Sir, that means triangle, check out for one-to-one correspondence, BC, BC, and the remaining by default is A, would be congruent to triangle, B corresponds to Q, this corresponds to R, and of course, by default QR, so it has to be P, by which test? AAS test of congruency. So my dear friends, once we have noted that, out of three angles, two have been proved. So one angle is yet left and two sides are yet left. So you can simply write, so angle B and C is covered. So angle A would be equal to angle P. What about the sides? So we can directly take the sides from here only, it will be better because it is one to one correspondence. Side AC has been considered. So we are left with BC. So can we say that side BC is equal to QR, and which other side is remaining? Sir, BC is covered, AC is covered, AB. So AB will be equal to, now note over here, AB should be equal to PQ, PQ. This is called as CPCTC. Corresponding parts of congruent triangles are congruent. So my dear students, this is so simple. I mean, like, you just need to understand what relevant information is given, and based on this information you have to devise what exactly would be the order. That order need to be verified from the test given to us. These are the test of congruency. It has to match to the test exactly in the same order without violating the norms of one-to-one correspondence, and you surely can get the relevant test. Let's move on to the next one. Let's move forward to the last test, that is RHS. First, understand the meaning. R stands R. This R letter R stands for right angle. H stands for
hypotenuse side, and this S stands for any other side of triangle. That means, my dear friend, one thing is for sure, ke RHS test can be applied only and only in right angle triangle. Understand one thing, my dear friends, मैं क्या बोल रहा हूँ आपको? RHS test सिर्फ और सिर्फ right angle triangle में applicable हो सकती है. It does not mean that हर right angle triangle में RHS test ही होगी. कोई भी right angle triangle में ऐसा भी हो सकता है कि RHS test ना हो, लेकिन RHS test को होने के लिए ट्राइंगल का राइट एंगल होना जरूरी है. व्हाट आई एम सेइंग इज दैट इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट दैट वी नो एंड वन मस्ट नो दैट RHS test इज पॉसिबल ओनली एंड ओनली इन अ राइट एंगल ट्राइंगल. बट इट इज ऑल्सो नॉट नेसेसरी दैट ऑल द राइट एंगल ट्राइंगल्स विल कन्फाइन और कैन बी प्रूव्ड ओनली बाय RHS test. We can prove right angle triangle are congruent even by using other relevant tests. Look at this triangle. Triangle ABC and triangle PQR. It is given to us that this side is equal to this side equals to this side. So my dear friends, when you go through these two right angle triangles, we say that, sir, side, angle, side. So triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR by SAS test. There is no RHS over here. Now look at this example. Have a look over here. So in this example, if you notice ABC, PQR, any relevant information given to us? Yes, sir. This equal to this, this equal to this, and this is also equal to this. So someone can say that, sir, I can use SAS, yes. Sir, I can also use SSS test, that is also right. So same triangles, you are using SSS test. Then you are using SAS test. We can also use RHS test also. R, right angle, yes, sir. Point number one, there. Point number two, hypotenuse, yes, sir. AQ equals to PR. Let me tell you, my friends, what is a hypotenuse side? In a right angle triangle, side opposite to 90 degree, side opposite to 90 degree is called as hypotenuse side. So for RHS test purpose, sir, one is a right angle, done. This one and one will match, corresponding to each other. This is hypotenuse side. So point number two, yes, the hypotenuse side. And third, any other side. So you can choose BC equals to QR, or you can even choose AB equals to PQ. So this particular triangle actually comply with test number 1, test number 2, test number 5. So my dear friends, you can imagine, it is not necessary that a particular set of triangles will be congruent to each other only by one test or just by one test. They can be congruent to each other by more than one test also. Then in that case, sir, what do we do? Do we have to mention all the tests? No, my dear friends. You have to choose any one test, which is the correct test, the relevant test, and you can prove as per any one of the tests. Now, for example, assume that we have triangle ABC and triangle PQR in this order. That is, so we have ABC, PQR, 90 degree, this side equals to this side, and they have also given us the information that this side is also equal to this side. So let us try. Sir, what if I apply SSS? For SSS, all three sides should be equal, so this is not applicable. Sir, SAS, SAS, for the purpose of proving these two triangles are congruent by SAS test, the two sides should include the angle. The two sides should include the angle, whereas this is not happening over here. as A, this angle should have been equal to each other. That means C should have corresponded to R, which is not happening. So definitely, I cannot even apply SAS test over here. What about ASA? For ASA, two angles should be given equal, but we have got only one angle which is equal, so ruled out. What about fourth one? So here also two angles should be there, but we have been given only one angle. So even possibility of four is ruled out. So we are forced to think beyond these four possibilities and move on to the fifth possibility, which is RHS. One more hint is that, sir, it is a right angle triangle, so 90 degrees is same. Also, hypotenuse side are same, and we want one more side. So can I say, in triangle ABC and triangle PQR, point number one, right angle. So can I say angle B equals to angle Q? Reason? So because each is 90 degree. That's given to us. Point number two, use hypotenuse, because that's the second point. Hypotenuse, that means side AC is equals to side PR. Reason? Hypotenuse side, and given to us, it's given to us. What about the third part? So side BC is equal to side QR, which is also given to us. So in the light of the given information, can I say triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR by RHS test of congruency? Since we have covered with one angle and two sides, so we are yet left with one side and two angles. Which side? So side AB will be equal to side PQ. And so as far as angle is concerned, angle C will be equal to angle R, angle A will be equal to angle P. This can be called as CPCTC. So my dear friends, wasn't it interesting to understand all the relevant tests of congruency, so that at least we have that fire in our engine to ensure that definitely we have understood the topic in depth, in detail, with most comprehensive concepts relevant for the purpose of congruency. There are many more things which are still essential to find out the hints. These were very small hints wherein which can be identified as two angles are equal or two sides are equal. Sometimes we are going to sketch a figure in such a way so that the triangles may be sharing common side or probably may be sharing a common angle. After doing all the four tests of congruency and the last one, that is RHS, so in all we have done five tests of congruency. As we discussed, for the purpose of congruency of the triangle, when we are proving that the two triangles are congruent, at that time our focus should be on the information that has been provided. There are two types of information that will be provided in the question. The one which will be obvious information. Now, what is obvious information? Sir, whenever the triangle is given to us, these are called obvious. This angle is equal to this angle, this side is equal to this side, and this angle equals to this angle. These are all called as an obvious information. We can easily demark and we can come to know that triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR, because obviously this angle is equal to this angle, this side is equal to this side, and this angle is equal to this angle. So 1 is equal to 1, angle 2, angle 2, and this side. So triangle ABC congruent to triangle PQR by ASA test. The information was quite obvious. In some cases, information may not be obvious. For example, if you look at triangle ABC, PQ, now in this, they are given to us this side is equal to this side and this side is equal to this side. So only two information is given to us. The information is side AO is equal to OQ and second side BO is equal to side OP. So my dear friends, just two information is given to us. We need minimum three information. So what is the third information? So we'll have to find out, and that is vertically opposite angles. Now what are vertically opposite angles? Whenever an X is formed something like this, so this angle and this angle, they will be always equal to each other, and they are called as vertically opposite angles. So here we have a case of vertically opposite angle. this was not given to us, so this was not obvious. But because of our inspection and because of our knowledge with respect to, we know there is something called vertically opposite angles, therefore these two angles are same. Similarly, even this angle will be equal to this angle. That is also vertically opposite angles. My dear friends, understand. Now this angle and this angle cannot be a vertically opposite angle. For a vertically opposite angle, a clear cut edge has to be there. So this angle will be equal to this angle. This is vertically opposite angle. This angle will be equal to this angle. This will be a vertically opposite angle. In our example, this angle will be equal to this angle. That's a vertically opposite angle. How many things we need? Sir, we need three things. So we already have three things. AO equals to OQ. That is one. BO equals to OP. That is two. And angle A equals to angle A. In short, angle AOB is equal to angle POQ. So how do we write that? Sir, which test is this? Side angle side. So a side angle side test will have to prove that they are equal. How do we go about? So we have to go in that order only. First is side. AO is equal to OQ. Second is, sir, angle AOB is equal to angle BOQ. And the third one, sir, side OB will be equal to OP. So basically all three things that is needed is available. AO equals to OQ, AOB equals to POQO. AOB equals to POQ, that is an angle. Over here, vertically opposite angles, this is given, even this is given. So my dear friends, triangle AOB is congruent to triangle AOB is congruent to QOP. You can check it out over here in the first line. O will be equal to O, so A is corresponding to Q. So AOB congruent to QOP by SAS test of congruence. What about the other things? Sir, of course, we know, sir. This is SAS. Two sides are done with. So we are still waiting for one more side. So one side, that is AB, is going to equal to PQ, that is CPCT. And as far as angle is concerned, angle A will be equal to angle Q, and angle B will be equal to angle P. These are all CPCTC. I hope we are aware about this thing. And the important learning from here is, even when obvious is not given or something like this is given to us, we can identify the vertical opposite angles. So main information was all about relevant for vertical opposite angles. So besides vertically opposite angles, one must also know the properties of the triangle. See, the property of the triangle is, we know that sum of all the angles of the triangle x, y, z. So you know that x plus y plus z equals to 180. This is sum of measure of all the angles of the triangle is 180. One must also know the property of a linear pair. Now what is linear pair? Sir, in this example, this is a line. Line actually, this particular line forms a pair of two angles. That is angle A and angle B. So angle A plus angle B is going to be a linear pair. And their total measure is going to be 180 degrees. Sum of measure of all the angles of the triangle would be 180 degrees. And besides that, one must also know the properties of parallel lines. Supposing if these two lines are parallel, so this line and this line is parallel, and this is a transversal, it is called as transversal. So basically, if you go to see in this, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. As far as corresponding angles concerned, we are talking about corresponding angles. When corresponding angles will be formed? So when there is a parallel line, line L parallel to line M. What is a transversal? So why is a transversal? So in this scenario, angle A will be equal to angle E, pair of corresponding angle. Angle B will be same way, B will be equal to F. second one. What about the third one, sir? C will be equal to G. C will be equal to G. And fourth one, D will be equal to H. So basically there are four pairs of corresponding angles. Where it will be useful to us? It will surely be useful to us whenever we will try and prove that the two triangles are congruent. When obvious things will not be given to us and we have to find things by ourselves. So during that time, this will be of the great help. Corresponding angles would be A equals to E, B equals to F. That means corresponding angle will always take the position of 1. You can check out. 1 will be equal to 5. 2 will be equal to 6, 3 will be equal to 7, and 4 will be equal to 8. These are the positions of the corresponding angles. Most important among all of them is alternate angles. Now, we can also call it interior alternate angles or alternate angles. Remember, my dear friends, whenever we are doing or finding an alternate angles, it has to form Z. Either normal Z or inverse Z. This pattern will always be seen and these two angles will be congruent. Like in this example, 1, 2, 3 and 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8, 4 will be equal to 6. That means 4 will be equal to 6. In other words, if you note it down, if you darken this line, you can check it out that this Z is formed as shown to you. So angle 4 will be equal to angle 6. Angle 4 will be equal to angle 6. In this example, it will be angle D. Angle D will be equal to angle F. D equals to F reasons the interior alternate. Same way, angle C. C will be equal to E. So C will be equal to E. Again, you can check it out. What letter it is forming? So it is forming inverse Z. Ulta Z form ho raha hai. So ye hai straight Z and ye hai reverse Z. This angle will be equal to this angle, that's called alternate angle. This angle is equal to this angle, that is also called as alternate angle. So when they will be useful? Sir, can you explain to us this with the help of two triangles where we can apply this congruency? Of course, yes. Let us see how it will come as an unobvious thing, wherein with our knowledge of parallel lines, we have to make it obvious. Look, for example, we have, it's given to us in the question, A, B, O, P, Q. It is given to us that this line is equal to, AB is parallel to PQ. This information is given to us. Besides this, one more information is given to us. AB is equal to PQ. Now in the light of this information, how do we prove that these two triangles are congruent? So point number one, since these two lines are parallel, so this can act as a transversal. OQ will act as a transversal. You can check there is a Z. Because lines are parallel, so application of Z is there. Check it out. So this angle will be equal to this angle. That means angle A will be equal to angle Q. Absolutely right. 1, 1. Sir, here also, sir, there is a Z. Reverse Z. Check it out. Yes. Angle 2 will be equal to angle 2. In other words, this angle, angle B, will be equal to angle P. Reason? Sir, these are alternate angles. And lastly, it's given to us that AB is equal to PQ. So AB equals to PQ. So what do you have? Saying, in other words, we can say that angle, side, angle. So angle, side, angle test can be applied to prove that these two triangles are congruent. In short, what am I proving to you? Sir, we have discussed about some of measure of all the angles of the triangle would be 180 degree. Absolutely fine. We have proved linear pair property. Absolutely fine. Then we also discussed about the parallel lines, where we know how to find out corresponding angles and the alternate angle. There is seemingly one more thing which is not that very much relevant. That means A, B, C and D. A plus B will always be 180 degree. They are called co-interior angle. B plus C will also be 180 degree. Remember, this two line has to be parallel. If these two things would have not been parallel, you cannot perform this operation of alternate angles. So the importance of parallel lines will be there definitely as far as congruency of triangles is concerned. In other words, जब भी सम आएगा जहां पे parallel lines दी होगी, question में दिया है कि ये triangle में ये दो line parallel है या कोई भी दो line parallel है, look out, check out for alternate angles. I am sure alternate angles or corresponding angles would be a hidden clue for you to find out the ingredients that are needed for the purpose of solving that the two triangles are congruent. Now let us say, for example, assume that the two triangles were given to me. The two triangles were 40, 70, 40, 60, and it was given to us 80 and 40, and it was also given to us this is equal. Now how can we prove that triangle ABC and PQR are congruent? So the answer is, the sum of measure of all the angles of the triangle is 180 40 60 100, so this would be 80. Sum of measure of all the angles of the triangle is how much? 180. So this is 80, so 100 left, 40, so 60 left. So now we got to know, sir, angle, side, angle, angle, side, angle. That's how we are going to use the property of sum of measure of all the angles of the triangle is 180. Dear friends, all this information and all the relevant properties have already been done in standard 6, 7th and 8th. But it becomes important to actually revise all of them, because now we'll be applying them for the purpose of proving that the two given triangles are congruent. I hope it was a wonderful class to give you an insight with respect to what all is needed for the purpose of proving that the two triangles are congruent. Let us start with the chapter and the exercise now.